Assalamu alaikum, everybody. It's me, Sister Lailani. Welcome back to my channel. Insha'Allah, you all are doing well. Alhamdulillah, I'm doing okay. It's been a while since I've put up a video. I was just thinking about what I wanted to put up. And because it's been a while since I've done a get to know me video, I know I have one in one of my lists, playlists somewhere, but I thought I'd do an updated get to know me video, inshallah. So if you are new to my channel, my name is Sister Lailani, and I'm a Niqabi, Muslima, hijabi, yeah. But let's see here. Why don't we go ahead and get started with the questions, inshallah. So that way you get to know who I am, my quirks and things like that, inshallah. I did jot down a bunch of questions, some, you know, just random questions and some not so random, I guess. I don't know. But inshallah, you will enjoy. And inshallah, I'll be able to get through these questions before my phone dies, because so quickly it went down from 64% to 48% in just less than a minute. So I don't understand with that. But we'll go ahead and start with, where did I grow up? I grew up in Texas, Houston, Texas, mainly. So, and now I live here in California. Do I prefer cats or dogs? I prefer cats. What's my favorite drink? Root beer. Root beer and cream soda. Let's see. And now apple juice. But it has to be a specific apple juice, like Langer's, I think, is the brand. Let's see. What's my spirit animal and why? I'd have to say a dragon. Now, I know that they are mythical, but that's my spirit dragon. I have loved dragons since forever. And then only recently, let's say about a few years ago recently, I learned that I was born in the year of the dragon. So that just makes a whole lot of sense. You're wearing perfume. What is it? Nothing. I do not like perfume. I can't stand to be around anyone who wears perfume, because I am extremely, extremely, extremely migraine sensitive. And so perfume is a no-go. That means anything I use cannot have perfume in it, or it has to have a very, very subtle, 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 barely there scent that will just dissipate. I can't use fragrant shampoos. I can't use fragrant body washes. I can't use fragrant dish soap. I can't even use the sprays, you know, to, you know, aerosol sprays to, you know, scent the house. I can't do that. So no perfumes. Any books that have changed my life, and what book is it? Well, there has been a couple of books, actually. One of them is a Bible, which led me to Islam, and which is, the Bible that led me to Islam. And another book that I read that took me a while to start reading. It was a book that was suggested to me. It's The Life of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I say it took me a while to read because it was suggested for me. And usually the type of books I like to read are fiction, you know, because they grab my attention and they hold my attention. When it comes to books of learning or books of somebody, it takes me a while to get into. But I'd say that the book that had me was the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In reading that book, I have got to learn so much about him. And by the time I got to the end of the book where he died, I cried so much because it was like losing my best friend, or losing, I don't want to say my best friend, but losing a very good friend. So that was another book. Let's see. My favorite YouTubers. Okay, if we're talking about Islamic YouTubers, I'd say Mufti Mank, Ali Dawa. Dawood Kim, Islamic Guidance, I think that's the channel. Yeah, Islamic Guidance. It's just a handful, but I usually watch them more. OMG Muslims, Shamsa. Yeah, mainly just those. If we're talking non-Islamic, then I'd say, I'm trying to think here. I wonder if I can visit those channels real quick. Let's see. Oh, an Islamic channel, Freshly Grounded. Okay. So, oh, and Khalid Al-Amiri. He is a Muslim who lives with his family in Abu Dhabi, I think. Yeah. Okay. Let's see. The Jess Life, I like to watch. KK and Baby J. Claire Chaboin with for Sim gaming channels, Sims 4 gaming channels, Ocean Sims. Yeah, mainly those, James Turner. Deligracy. Those are the channels I like to watch when I want to watch someone play The Sims, like Let's Plays or build channels, things like that. So that's just to name a few. And I did find another channel I like to watch that is a Muslim channel. It's Dawood Savage, and where'd it go? Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Samantha Boyle. And oh yeah, I was right, Islamic Guidance. Yeah, I was right on that channel. Okay, let's see. Languages I speak well. English sometimes, even though it's my primary language. Sometimes I feel like I can't speak it. You get off me. But English. I wish I could speak German well, Spanish. I wish I could speak Spanish well. I speak very, 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 very little of Spanish, and even smaller amounts of German. But I wish I could speak those well. I wish I could speak Arabic well. I want to learn Japanese as well as Korean, because I do have plans in the future, hopefully the near future, to go to Japan and South Korea, inshallah. How would I describe my fashion sense? Very simple. I wear abayas anytime I go out, mostly German, mostly jersey abayas. I'll just let this guy go by first. Okay, so mostly jersey abayas. when I go out because it's comfortable. And underneath, I usually wear my pajamas or something comfortable. So I'm a very simple dresser. I don't really care for any fashionable things. It's just not my mindset. I don't really care for that kind of thing. So my fashion sense is very, very simple and comfortable. And usually I either go out in sneakers or slippers. And that's basically it. Oh, let's see. How many siblings do I have? I have 4. My favorite go-to fast food order. I don't usually visit any fast food chains. I used to a long time ago, but I don't anymore. So if I was to get any fast food, it would be from a Muslim owned shop, like HFC, which is Halal Fried Chicken. I used to get food from there, but they moved. The place that I will go to that I know of is Faisal, and it's usually lamb kebabs. I love a good lamb kebab. Any bad habits? I say alike. Oh my gosh, I say a lot. Yes, I say a lot. Any good habits? Yes, I mean, if you consider it a good habit, I say bismillah before I put food in my mouth, before each bite, and before each... There are bugs flying around me. It's annoying. Sorry. There are bugs flying around me. Okay, so I say bismillah before each bite or before each sip. Mainly I do that because sometimes I feel like I forgot to say it. So I've been in the habit of saying it before each bite and before each sip of drink I take. So yes, I say that's a very good habit. One that I can't shake. Let's see. Favorite surah and why? My absolute favorite surah, and if you've already known me on this channel, it is Surah Al-Ikhlas. And why? Because it talks about the oneness of Allah, that there's no God but the one and only God. That's something that I've believed since the Old Testament of the Bible. So I say Surah Al-Ikhlas in every salah I make. Every salah, without fail, I say it. I recite it. So it's Surah Al-Ikhlas. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakun lahu kufuwan ahad. Say He is Allah, the one and alone, the one and only. Allah, the absolute, the eternal absolute. He begets not, nor is He begotten, and there is none like unto Him. That is my favorite surah, hands down. It is short, it is sweet, it basically reiterates what I've believed all of my life. My favorite reciter, when it comes to me learning Quran, or not learning Quran, but learning how to recite well, or well enough, is Mishari Rashid. If I wish I had a favorite female reciter, but I can't seem to find one that I can constantly learn under when I go to recite Quran. So, you know, something I could just turn on and just listen to her and just and recite from her. So that's where my struggles with Quran recitation comes from, is that usually I learn from male reciters. And so I adopt or adapt to their way of reciting. So it sounds too much for my voice to handle. So yeah. If I could live or visit anywhere, where would that be? If I could live anywhere, it would be Japan. I'd say the countryside of Japan or the countryside of South Korea. I would live there, visit and live there. Visit first so I could see, you know, all the beauty that is there, and then live there. And if I'd say my final retirement place I want to go to or live in, it would be Medina. Let's see, my favorite movie, Moana. My favorite TV show. Right now, it is a Chinese drama. It's called Rui's Love in the Palace. I have been binge watching that, and I'm still watching it. So that's my favorite favorite show right now. Favorite coffee order. Gosh, why am I forgetting right now? It is a caramel mocha frappuccino. Is it caramel mocha? I think it's caramel mocha frappuccino. Pet peeves. Me saying a lot. I do not like tapping. I don't even like the sound of knocking on doors. I don't like constant interruptions. And lately, my daughter has been doing that, where she'll burst through the door. Well, not burst through the door, but she'll open the door and just start talking. And she'll do that multiple times if she can't complete the thought. She'll do that multiple times. So that's been incredibly annoying. Let's see. The biggest struggle I overcame. The biggest struggle... I don't know if I so much as overcame it, but I have a difficulty trusting people. So that's my struggle. I've been hurt a lot in my life, and so trusting people is not something that I can do so easily. I have to get to know the person and their intention for me. It's that. And I'm very quiet and very reserved. So that's another struggle. And it comes with the hurt that came, that was behind it. So if that makes any sense. Favorite fruits. Cherries, pomegranates, mainly it's cherries and pomegranates. It used to be bananas, but I don't eat bananas a lot anymore because I get sick and tired of those. So it's cherries and pomegranates. If you were to say my favorite vegetable, then it'll be artichokes. Favorite desserts. Oh my gosh. Since I have become Muslim a long time ago, I have come across a dessert that I absolutely love so much, and that's jalebi. I tried so hard to find jalebi last year that I ended up giving up because I couldn't find it. Introvert or extrovert? I am an introvert. Favorite places to shop? Okay. So if we're talking about for abayas, I say my favorite place to shop, if I had a steady flow of money, it would be Shukr. Shukr. It would be Shukr. That is like a high-end Target for me. but for regular abayas, it would be East Essence. Do you listen to music? If so, what? I do listen to music. Growing up, I listened to my favorite bands, which were Aerosmith, ZZ Top, Bryan Adams, it used to be, what's his name? I can't remember his name. But that's the type of music I listened to growing up. I like listening to rock and alternative. So yes, Evanescence has been my favorite. Pink was for a short time, along with Alanis Morissette for a short time. As of late, it has been BTS. I know, don't roast me in the comments for it. Let me tell you why. I didn't really get into BTS first. The first person from BTS that caught my attention was someone by the stage name of Suga. Or Min Yoongi is his first, is his full name, his given name. And he was the first person that I started listening to when I was in a rut, when I was feeling really down with my health, and I was at the peak of my anxiety, at the peak of stress, everything. So he was the first person that I listened to before I listened to BTS, and the song that caught my attention that I was able to relate to him with was a song called The Last, where he talked about his struggles with depression, anxiety, social anxiety, which is something that I suffer from, and suicide, which is something that I had struggled with in my younger days. So I was able to relate to him with that. And so when I researched him, that's when I learned that he was part of a group called BTS, Bangtan Sonyeondan. And I listened to them mainly because of their lyrics. I know there's going to be, don't roast me in the comments regarding music. I know. But my thing is, I don't listen to anything that does not have any real value to me. Okay? So when I listen to music, the lyrics has to be of value. If it doesn't uplift me, if it doesn't take me out of a rut, if it doesn't make me feel better, if it doesn't make me relate, then I won't listen to it. So it has been BTS as of late. And so if I ever had a chance to go to their concerts, I would definitely go. Because again, their music, which is their lyrics, not the, you know, the sound, it's the lyrics that I will listen to. I won't listen to anybody else unless they have lyrics that have value to me. If there is this artist that has lyrics that has absolutely no value to me, I will not give them a first listen, okay? I have to look at the lyrics. If the lyrics are something that I can connect to, then you're fine. If it's not, then I don't want to hear it. So that's it. And that is, I covered music and a covered bands. So that's it. That's all the questions that I jot down. If you have any other questions, inshallah, just let me know in the comments below. I will try and do another video answering your questions. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Inshallah, you enjoyed. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Leave a comment, subscribe if you have not already done so. If you have not already done so, and inshallah, I will see you in another video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Oh, if you guys do go out, please make sure that you social distance, wear a mask to protect yourself as well as others around you. And inshallah, I'll see you next time. Assalamu alaikum. Bye.